Cashman Williams, and our beloved sister, Lovett Dubu, as well.
Amen.
If any of you who have any reason why these two should not be joined as one, you better come up now or forever hold their peace.
You can run, but you can't hide. Because I'll find you. And if I can't have you, you can't.
No!
Someone help me!
Yes, how is it going at the wedding, sir?
Right now, we are in the hospital. Someone shot my daughter's husband in the church.
What? My God, why? Yes, sir. Just calm down, sir. Calm down. Take it easy. Was he apprehended?
No. It is not a man. Shot herself as well. Can you imagine that?
Christ. This is complicated. How do we go about it, sir?
That's why I called you. Why are you talking like this? I wasn't trained in your profession. Yes. Please. Thank you.
Yeah, sure. Jesus.
Okay, I hope you die when you disturb again.
This is unbelievable. A lady shot a guy at his wedding, shot him dead, and she also shot herself.
So now I get again, my.
This is unbelievable, Chief Ewu.
How is she?
We seem to be lucky here.
You know, I really pity the dead man's wife.
She will deal with it. Who could be responsible for her action?
Well, the police will come out with that answer later. You know, I have this feeling she must have been hurt real bad.
I agree with you.
What could have made her kill a man on his wedding day? Heartbreak? I mean, that's not enough reason for her to take a man's life.
Only I have the answer to these questions.
Well, let's hope she survives. Maybe we'll get to hear the story someday.
It's okay.
Girl this young has such a deadly heart. Hey!
Corporal Simpson.
Yes, sir.
That is the odd reflection of the reputation of our rising generation.
China is shitty square. And there can never be any meaningful solution to the dreadful false power without a draconian action. Doctor.
Yes.
Are you sure she's not dead?
She's alive, but we need to keep her here a little longer.
I don't get it.
She's in a pretty bad shape.
Then shape her up! Listen, she caused a lot of damage.
Inspector, this is a hospital. We don't need noise. Calm down. When she's okay and ready to answer your questions, I'll give you a call.
Yes. It's quite pathetic. But what do I say? Other than please accept my sympathy.
Don't spare her. No matter how hard those doctors try to protect her, she killed my husband.
It's okay. Please. Sorry, it's madam. Okay. Please, I'm really sorry about that. Please relax, okay? Don't get worked up, okay? I promise you will pay for it.
Inspector, what sort of future generation of people are we rearing? Our women have completely turned into scary objects. I used to think that no matter how hard one thought a woman's heart could be, it was devoid of cold-blooded murder.
Come on, Daddy. That beast is not a woman. She's not even human. Inspector, she sprung from an alien planet.
An alien planet, you say? Then leave her to me. I will teach her that in this planet of ours, we have laws that prohibits murder.
I hope so.
Papa Simpson, see me in my office immediately.
It's Inspector.
You still can't have it.
Doctor, why? Now listen, Doctor. You can't go on preventing the course of justice. She's lived life out of someone. And I guess you know what that means. Murder. So she does not deserve the protection you are calling her.
Inspector, I do know justice must take its due course.
Inspector, you wouldn't have interrogated her cop if she were dead. We are professionals here.
Doctor, I did not expect that from you. Tread carefully.
Inspector, you're necessarily impatient and hasty.
Would you to let her leave for you? Certainly you're not going to interrogate a whore with nothing in it. Are you?
What are you insinuating? Look, Inspector, what she's trying to say is she's blank at the moment. She can't remember anything. Look, I plead with you. Why don't you just let her stay here till next week? We'll get to monitor her till then. Please. Next week.
I guess we should. I guess so, sir, but they had better not try anything for you. That is my
have relations?
I don't know. No one seems to care to pay her a visit.
Why would they? It's obvious. I know her kind of person. She's the type that will not let anyone know it when she was planning it.
Yes! You speak in that manner!
She sure wouldn't tell anyone of such plan. I don't understand why anybody has not come for her.
Yes. What? Okay, 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 okay. I'll talk to you later. Please, I'll talk to you later.
What in God's name is wrong with these doctors?
What is
this? The inspector said they wouldn't let them take the girl again.
But anyway, she killed my husband.
Are you sure they don't have a hand in this?
Don't say that. They are doctors. Doctors who support injustice. Can you imagine? Damn. They gave the police 1 week. Just 1 week.
No, they want to help her escape.
They will do no such things. Let's wait until then. Please.
No, no, it's okay. It's okay. Please.
Thank you.
I mean, how could we forget that she previously attempted taking her own life?
Do you think she could attempt it again?
Of course, you do know the number of times the police have been here. So that's why the reason she will try to do it over and over again.
You think she shot herself to evade the law?
I really don't know what to think. But what I do know for sure is, if anything happens to her, we'll be deeply immersed in the deep, deep tussle with those men in black.
This is a bad one. Why did they even bring her here?
Because patients are treated and cured here. Listen, we'll be doing ourselves a whole load of good if we put everything she can lay her hands on away in that world. I mean everything, including pieces of paper.
It has to be done.
Please believe me. Nurse, can you not find the nurses? Let them keep close watch on her.
Sky, I'm changing.
I'm changing.
Sky. been dreaming. No tears for my crying. No tears for my crying. Dead to a feeling. Life's lost all its meaning. Have I been dreaming?
What's she doing? She's sound asleep. She had better be. There's so much for her. I'm not sure the law will spare her. It's obvious she doesn't know the consequences of her actions. Moreover, she doesn't seem to treasure her life a bit.
You're right, you know. She tried to take it at the church and was here. And if she had an opportunity, I think she could do it again.
I bet.
Alright. What is wrong, doctor?
My God. My God, oh my God.
See somebody here by this time of the day for our hospital now.
Oh. Ah. But it's just 11 now. That's not too late now, or is it?
Oh God, the instruction my chairman gave me say once this time don't reach, when nobody can see anybody for our hospital. So if you go, come back tomorrow morning.
Sorry, but does that include those with metals?
Now what can English be this one, those with metals? Now say anybody, everybody, and you know be everybody. I don't understand these those with metals, so break out for me.
Okay, okay. You want to know, right? You really want to know?
Yes.
Good.
Hospital seems to have brought in some security personnel without our knowledge, so they overpower our men.
Can you hear yourself? Because to me, that is the most.
I'll come see you before you leave. Just rest.
time I see you. What am I hearing? What am I doing? Have I been dreaming? No tears for my crying. Dead to a feeling. Lost all its meaning. Have I been dreaming?
Studies.
Fine. Yes.
Oh, well done. That's my girl. So where's your friend?
Supriya.
Yes.
She went home.
Which home? Okay, you mean the village?
No, your house. Where I usually come to see her.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Is there anything wrong with her phone? Because we have been trying to get her for over a week now, but no answer.
No. Before she left, her phone was okay.
Are you sure what you're telling me?
Yes, I saw her off to the park. Did she get home?
Gracious Father, please, please, please wait. Same thing. Her phone is not going through. Did she leave any forwarding address as in where she's going to?
No, she just told me she was going home. I even saw her off to the park.
Oh, oh my God. Are you sure? Oh my God. Oh God. I'll get back to you, okay?
I'll get in touch with you, please.
I don't know how this happened. I'm amazed myself. I got a call from the nurses last night and they told me...
Dr. Charles.
Dr. Charles. You have a lot to explain about this. A lot. I wanted this girl. But you refused. Why? Why? I don't know. Now she's dead. She's dead. Perhaps there's more to this.
Please, Inspector.
Will you shut up? You refused to allow me interrogate a blank head. A head with nothing. Professionals you are. Professionals, my foot. You'll hear from us soon.
And not a chance.
Make sure nothing happens to this corpse.
I said it. This is pure conspiracy.
These people, these doctors conspired hard to kill my husband.
It's not that.
I can bet with my life. Those doctors are aware of what happens to Kashmir.
If I should ask, what business does Kashmir have with them? He is not a doctor. And had no hospital business he was running.
Then, why did they refuse to release her to the police?
I should be asking you that. He was your best friend. I never knew either of you from Adams before you came for my daughter's hand in marriage.
Maxwell, where are you going?
Can you imagine that?
Where does he think he's going?
Doctor, listen. What in heaven's name do you expect me to do with a dead body? No. The case has been charged to court. So let it remain so, please.
Sure, sir. You called me, sir?
Yeah, I did.
Corporal.
Sir.
I want you to study this document before they are sent to court.
Yes, sir.
Sir, is this necessary?
What do you mean?
I'm sorry, sir, but honestly, the doctors didn't mean any harm. Sir, it's just unfortunate that the girl died.
Then why didn't they let me have her when I wanted her?
Sir, you know as well as I do that we wouldn't have achieved anything with her head empty.
But we would have at least still had her breathing. Now listen, Corporal, there's no emotional attachment in this. We now have two murder cases in our hands. And I want the doctors to come and say what they know about them in court.
Yes, sir. Sure, sir.
Then we were talking about my husband that was murdered on my wedding day. By a lady, and the doctors involvement in this case.
over what could have led to her shooting him.
I knew he had other girlfriends before me.
And what exactly transpired between them? Do you know? No woman in this land shoots a gun.
That's what you think. They can even throw bombs nowadays.
With genuine reasons.
Dear, these girls are desperate. She could do it for money.
You mean at the expense of her life? Who would she be bequeathing the money? Her children? My dear, that was a girl with a future that should be better than that.
If her life were better than anything, she wouldn't have dared to terminate her life.
See what I mean? He hurt her destiny. I believe he destroyed it. This case is not worth fighting. I quit.
You what?
You heard me? I said I quit! Chief! Chief, come back here!
Preventing her from being in your custody. And when we did tell you she was dead, you said I had lots of explanation to make. Well, here she is now. You can have her do whatever. She leaves now. You have a nice day, Inspector.
Your crime, what brought you here? I killed somebody.
I'm waiting for the hangman. He doesn't seem to be coming. I wonder why.
You mean you'll be hung?
It's better than the life I live. Living hurts me so much. And each time I try to take my life, something wakes me up. I wonder why.
What kind of a person are you? Why do you hate to leave? Could you just tell me what the person did to you?
Yes, hello, sir. Yeah, this is Kashmir speaking. You may not know me, sir, but I was, I was over at your office some time ago, and you told me to call you this week to see if we can, so I don't know if, should I come now? For the job, yes, for the job offer. Oh, well, sir, you told me this week. Next month. Okay, sir, no problem, sir. Thank you, sir, yes. Yeah, hello, sir. Yeah, good day, sir. This is Kashmir. I was at your office last week, and then you told me that I should for the job interview. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sir? My name is Kashmir Williams. I was at your office for a job interview some time back. I'm just calling to find out if there's any luck, sir. Sir, but you promised me, sir. There must be something you can do for me, sir. My credits are really, really good. Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
That is true. Making it five. Oh.
How much is that?
150.
What do you mean 150?
5 minutes you make now.
It's not 20 bucks.
I sit as five, waiting again. 150, start 30 now. Don't make for 20 now.
What are you talking about now? It's 2020. Everybody makes call for 20 bucks.
For your village or for Lagos.
What do you mean?
It's not teach me my job. Now, I bet I do something inside. Give me my money, my come out here. My mama wants to pay my money.
Yeah.
Because where you pick this one now? Anyway, remember 50 naira.
That is all I have. If you turn me upside down, you can't find any. Nothing will jingle.
Yeah, pay my money now. Which one be this? I said I do something. Give me my money, my come out here.
You're a rogue.
Thank you. Pay me my money.
If you like, turn me upside down. There is no other money.
I don't be upside down, man. I pay my money. Somebody turn you upside down.
I don't have. It's 20 bucks. Everybody takes 20 now.
My money.
Everybody takes 20 now.
Why would I know you're
saying you're doing yours for 20 bucks?
We are making ours. Our own is 30 naira, not 20 naira, and you must pay my money before you leave.
I must pay you.
Simple.
Stop me.
Pay money. No, they look me that kind of face, yeah. If you're afraid, no, look me that kind of face. Pay my money, ah. Oh, no, they fear me. Pay my money, ah. Who the school's face? Pay my money. Stop, I'm it's okay.
Sorry, what seems to be the problem?
Imagine this man, will come make call. 5 minutes, that is 30 naira. 30 times 5, 150, and he's giving me 100 naira. Stop that nonsense, ah.
Is it because of 50 naira?
Not just because, it's 50 naira. Pay my money.
But listen, just give him back his money, I'll pay.
150. Yes. I'm not collecting anything like that. 150. Take your money. You know they look me like that. Ah. God bless you. Where might I give you your change?
Thank you very much.
It's okay.
I really appreciate the gesture. I must.
It's okay. Bye.
God bless you, Jared. Take your change now. Auntie,
thank you.
God bless you. No matter that idiot, too. You come here, come make up. That you see the home, you come here, come do rubbish. God make up, punish you. Man, you see.
Steve, man, you couldn't understand the level of embarrassment, the depth of humiliation I went through. If not for the intervention of that girl, you know what she did for me? Ah, they for seize me down now.
The way you sound, you make the whole situation look like it's a miraculous situation. Come on, I mean, a girl walked in, saved a situation and walked out, and you never got to know who she is? Come on, Cash, who be this girl?
I don't know. I don't know. But the girl did.
I would say you listen to yourself. Girl, we can enter a situation, got you out of it. Then you don't fit accent who she be, but you still don't say the girl did. You just don't make her say, look, Cash, where I said.
You know me now, Steve. You know me now. If you see that Cash back in those days, I forgot enter that babe. Sharp, sharp. Maybe I think I was just carried away by the embarrassing situation that I just totally for me. That girl not better me too. Anyhow, Sha, no long thing at all. As long as I say that girl did this time, I go get her.
You know what you make me laugh? I remember back in the days when they call you the Lord of the Hunters. Come and say that you girl now can't put for this condition. You know? But as if you say, you only tell me the reason. Honestly, let's say you go ahead, thank you, sort yourself out. They come tell me the reason. They can go here, yeah, how you do. The whole thing is called back.
Nah, man, I don't know who you are. Steve-O, my brother. They go on that fruitless job hunt again. Thank God did my side. I just know say one day all this affair will stop.
Are you sounding as if the whole world is coming on down on you? The crazy man. You know how I started. Now see where I did now. You understand? So don't worry, everything will be okay. You know? I just wish you luck.
Also, I just hope the incident of yesterday is not a sign of misfortune.
You make me laugh, Cash. You mean at this age and time you still believe in superstition? Come on, man. Listen up. Give it a 5 man. Yes. Oh, man.
That's right,
man. Man. Is he going on?
Does it? What am I hearing? What am I doing?
Hey! Hi, gentlemen. What? You don't remember me?
Oh, yes, sorry, yeah. You're the girl that saved me the last time. Yeah, thank you.
How are you?
I'm fine.
You look good.
Thank you.
Well, if you're so much in a hurry, or maybe you have a very long way to go, the cab is waiting.
No, thank you. I'll just walk.
Why? Come on, ride with me.
You know what? I think you should run along. Yeah, because, I mean, it's costing you so much money keeping that cab waiting there, you know. Okay, you win.
Thanks. Come on, let's go.
You know what, I really want to thank you for what you did for me the last time.
Oh, come on, it's nothing. How are you?
I'm fine. Life is tough, but we get by. Honestly, you saved me a lot of embarrassment that day, you know. I couldn't do much than to just walk away.
There you go. Anyway, before you walk away this time, be nice enough to leave me with your name.
Ah, damn. Okay, you beat me to that one. My name is Kashmir. You got one?
Of course. Supriya.
Is that Nigerian?
No. Actually, my mom borrowed it from an Indian friend of hers.
I don't care if your mom stole it from an Afghan friend. That's the name to beat. So what were you up to?
Actually, I was going for shopping pickups. You know.
Oh, shopping. I was job hunting. Going job hunting. I don't know. It's so tough to get a job these days.
Please, confident. This year, I'm sure that definitely will work for second time as well. I was seasons before that, but in fourth position, I stuff like this.
Yes, who's
there?
Who's there? Quite shocking, you know, seeing you here at the door. I mean, but it's still good. It's still good that you came. I really liked it. Oh, please sit down.
Thank you.
Yeah. So, what do I offer you?
Nothing. I'm perfectly fine.
Ah, come on, man. Anything? Water, soft drink.
Cashmere. I'm fine.
I'm not there at all. Oh, Steve. Hi. What's up?
Alright. Hi, Zubi.
Who do we have here? Oh.
I'm another girl I told you about.
Oh, she's so gorgeous.
Hi.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
Supriya, meet Steve. Steve, meet Supriya.
It's a pleasure.
Steve is my very good friend.
You look beautiful.
Thank you.
He's housing me here.
I've heard so good things about you.
Really? Good things or bad things?
What I said, good things about you. Cash, we should have something in the fridge.
Oh, no, please. I'm perfectly fine.
Come on, it's your first time here.
Maybe next time. Please.
I've been talking to her about it. She refused.
Thank you.
So,
Cash.
Yeah.
Could we possibly go somewhere else? Anywhere?
Right now? Why, you? You don't like it here?
Oh no, it's beautiful. I just wanted us to be alone.
Oh. Sure.
Now?
Yeah, let's go.
Why not? Come see, it's really a pleasure. Thank you.
Me too. Take care of yourself.
Alright, bye.
Cash? Yeah. I'll catch you around, man.
It's pretty hard though, but at least one thing you're saying about it does have bread for you.
What if it does? No, don't drop it.
No.
So hot.
Yeah.
I can't drop it.
Cash. Yep.
She wanted you nothing.
I've not even finished this when you're asking for anything else. Don't damn you. I can finish everything you have in your purse right now.
Really? Spare me all that self-pity and patronage. I don't have a hole in my purse.
Oh, really? So you came well prepared, huh?
Well prepared.
Thank you, man, but you've been feeding me fat. Look at me, I'm so big. I mean, look at me. What, do you want to feed me till I bust?
There's no space in there. Whoa. There's no space.
Yeah, I know, but I want to be like, you know, like a model. Yeah, not like fat, chubby, whatever. I don't want that.
Yeah,
anyway, thank you. Thank you very much. You've been really, really nice. Wonderful.
There you go. Thank you. Christ. Very uncomfortable with that.
I'm sorry.
Anyway, you haven't told me what you were doing before.
What I was doing before? I was shoplifting. I'm just kidding. Of course, I was kidding. Nothing. I wasn't doing anything.
Nothing. What do you mean, nothing?
I mean, nothing. I wasn't doing nothing at all. I mean, I finished my youth service like a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
I've been to virtually every office in this city.
Mm-hmm.
All to no avail. No luck.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, it's nothing.
How have you been coping?
Oh. Steve. My cousin, he's been like a mini god to me.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's been of immeasurable assistance to me.
And he looks like a nice person.
Well, he is. He's my cousin and he's just a great guy.
Oh,
goodness. Uh-huh.
Somebody's definitely going to get best of that person this
time.
I'm thinking. Maybe I should introduce you to one of my father's friends. I guess they can help.
Really? I really appreciate that. Yeah. Right. Of course. I mean, anything to get a job, anything.
So, it's a deal.
Great, a deal. Cheers.
Fina, come on. Look, I know you like him the moment you see him. What is there to like about someone you don't know much about? Eh?
It's not out of the ordinary. I mean, he's handsome and gentle. Really?
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
Just that?
Yes, just that.
Now tell me, what does he do?
Nothing, but he's a graduate. He's just out of a job for now. What?
What is there to like about a jobless graduate? Eh? When you have thousands of graduates out there with mouth-watering jobs.
Fina, that is an inequitable way of talking. Oh. Habba, he's not going to remain jobless all through now. By the way, what matters most is that he's a nice guy. You know, he's cute, he's gentle, he's subtle. He's just different.
Good
Good luck then. Tell me, for how long have you known him to be able to draw a conclusive assessment of him?
Fina, how can you be so archaic? I mean, I don't have to know him for the 21 years, 10 months, and 3 weeks I've been on this earth. The important thing is that he's sweet. Really, he's different. He's everything. Really, you like him.
I just hope you don't get disappointed.
No,
because they come as saints at first, and before you know it, they turn you into a piece of rubbish. And before you say, Jack Robinson, you're gone.
Try and be optimistic for once.
I think I'm through with you for now.
Dreaming of your love. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, really, he's different. Mm-hmm. He's sweet and he's nice. I think you're jealous.
Mm. Kashmir, you're different. She doesn't know yet.
I've been everywhere around this city, virtually everywhere.
Really? How come? Were you born and bred here, or you weren't a taxi driver?
No. It's just that ever since I got into the unemployment market, I've been around. And I've seen lots of girls. But none as beautiful as you.
Thanks.
I mean every word I've said. You are a very beautiful woman.
And you're also a very wonderful person to be with. And handsome too.
I like you very much.
I like you too.
Supriya, yeah. I don't know how to say this to you. I can't seem to find the appropriate words. You know, I can't seem to find the appropriate words to express how I feel inside, you know, deep inside. It's right there, but I just can't seem, I don't know if you understand what I'm trying to say.
Father, I understand. And no other words could be more suitable.
Imagine how happy to be tonight.
Oh boy. I'm telling you, Steve, I still don't believe it. That there are girls in this country that wouldn't make a guy lose his hair in the process of trying to prophesy his love to them. I can't believe it. It's unbelievable.
I agree with you. Our girls have really gone haywire. But they're not so cheap and loose.
I am telling you, Steve, that this girl confessed to me from the onset that she had always loved me.
So how are you feeling like? You mean you're telling me that her benevolence was a signal for your attention?
What are you trying to say now, Steve? Then why did you tell me to get acquainted with her in the first place?
Is that where you're coming from, Cash? You misunderstood me completely. She was just being nice. I mean, like someone acting on impulse. A good friend. Remember what she did for you. Not someone you will sleep with and break her heart.
I have heard you, Mr. Good Boy, so I'm now the heartbreaker.
I'm serious. That girl is a good one.
Mm.
And I know a good girl when I see one.
Thank you very much.
For real.
I have heard you now, Mr. Good Boy. Let me go and take off my clothes. I'm sweaty.
Cash. No, really, I'm serious. I'm not joking.
That was how we met. I jumped off. It went on like that until it developed into a full moon of affair.
there that helped him to be judge. Your parents know him. His name rang a bell in my house. He bought me lots of things. Lots of beautiful things. Roses. Gifts. He sent it through local courier service. Everybody admired it so much. Including my father.
What does your father do?
He's a chief judge to a high court.
He can't be serious. And you're here at the mercy of death?
Nobody knows I'm here. They don't know my whereabouts. I came here from school. And this place is far from both my home and my school. Those nurses and doctors who took care of me are my people now. At least they'll be there on my dying day.
Oh, stop it! I hate you when you talk like this.
Our neighbor, and that he's very close to this family.
Supreme, my daughter, that's not a priority here. I wonder if you know how many people have been murdered in cold blood in this country on a daily basis. Do you know the number of criminals that are bound to the length and breadth of this country? There are millions of people there, voiceless people like that, whose rights have been trampled upon. And when I sit back as a law officer to look at all this, I feel it is not proper. I swore to an oath to defend and uphold the law. And so I'm advocating that the earlier the law prevails in this country, of course, the better for everybody. Yes.
But my dear, it still baffles me why you did not save that boy. I mean, you had all it takes, all within your power to save his life.
Murderers like him are not supposed to live. Why must he live? If you allow him to live, he will endanger, obviously, the lives of innocent people. And that I won't do.
But Dad, he's not a murderer. It's just a mere mistake, Dad.
Chima, you can say that again. But let me tell you, you go out there and do exactly what he did, as if I would nail you. Human life is very precious. Nobody ever toys with it. Did you hear that? Nobody ever toys with human life. Is that correct?
Yes.
Good.
My father will have condemned me. He did the same to our neighbor. He sent him to life imprisonment.
That's like going to hell when you have a godfather in heaven. What did your neighbor do?
He was playing with his girlfriend. Then she fell and died. I guess I'll have done the same if I were in his shoes.
Sometimes she frees my blood. He didn't mean to kill her.
I thought so initially. Until he explained things to me. He would play rough and dangerous to people. It could be your own person who would die. How would you take him?
Okay. What did Kashmir do to you?
Kashmir?
Cash, man.
Sexual. You know what? If you're a wood, I am not a wood. I'm human. I have blood flowing through my veins.
You have to understand.
Understand what? That you're a piece of furniture?
That unmarried people are not supposed to have sex. I can't do it until I'm married.
What? To whom? A saint? Like someone who's never met a woman before in his life? Is that what you're talking about? You know what? It's very, very obvious that this whole thing is beyond you, so I'll just look elsewhere.
No, please. Please. You can't do this to us. I mean, you can't allow sex to tear us apart. Please. Gosh, please. I see that you need some time alone. I'll just leave you.
Cash, where your woman? Follow me here now. Where your woman? She don't go.
She's left.
What's happened?
What I can't fathom is why she wouldn't make love to me.
Make love? That's why you didn't think like this. You know, see all these girls, they frustrate person. We don't know the way they pull their own. So you're not supposed to allow that kind of thing to frustrate you. You're not a guy now. You understand? And there is nothing in lovemaking. She they feel me so. Except say the girl don't see another guy outside with his strap and wear, with the comb and well emily wet. Then why? But all these girls are the same.
She doesn't believe in premarital sex.
After all those kissing, smooshing, where is the smoosher? Why should they dull herself now? Nobody wish she dull, she they dull herself. Forget that, no let them tell you stories. Oh. All those online, nah, nah, oh, up my hands in the hands. Oh. I just up my hands, oh. No believer. Forget that thing. I tell you, down on yes.
Man, Maxwell, I'm just so disoriented. I'm sick and tired of this girl's obstinate resistance to my sexual advances.
Make I tell you something. If girl gets outside, they're going to pretend to you, say, man, they are good, they are innocent. All those ones are story. Okay, imagine me and Bola, old school days, the way they move together. See, the way we play our rounds those days. So why the dollar?
Waiting concern me and your story with Bola. At the talk of waiting, they disturb me, they talk Bola.
Don't be saying for the
I really do. And
don't want him in another girl's arms.
Then you have to be ready to get it to him.
Fina!
You don't want to lose him. So that's the only possible way out. Come think of it, who is he anyway?
I'm just tired of losing those I love. I'm tired of it.
You see? Men snoop for it. Even when they have 24/7. Not to talk of when they've been denied of it completely.
I'm just so confused. I don't know what to do.
You're no longer a child, so I think you should understand all this by now.
You're right.
Can't you let go of him?
You friend or an enemy? Yourself. Gosh, we can't do it at the bathroom, in the kitchen, at the balcony, in the bedroom, anywhere, anytime, but please.
And that is all bullshit! You know what? Until then, Supriya, that's the door.
Gosh, what do you mean?
You heard me.
I love you very much. Don't do this to us, please. 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 That day, I lost my virginity. I hated him for it. And gradually, it became the order of the day.
That is the problem.
He comes to visit me in school. And we continued unguardedly until I became pregnant.
Christ! You could have used contraceptive drugs or something, you know, like
I just hated drugs of any description.
See, that was a very grievous mistake.
I know. I got to know later. He insisted on an abortion and I vehemently refused. Even though I knew my parents would kill me if they found out. I still refused. I said no. I still refused.
To have an abortion. marriage now. It's rather premature for me.
Is that what you'll say? I never wanted sex. But your flat wouldn't stay zipped. Now you've destroyed my life.
Supriya, I couldn't resist you. I was so attracted to you, I just couldn't help it. Besides, we're both mature people. You and I. We should do mature things.
You should have thought of that before you were demented by the animal instinct in you.
Have you thought about this? Have you thought about your future? Your family background? Have you?
I don't want an abortion. And I'd rather abandon my career, my family. I could have the baby elsewhere.
Listen to yourself. Listen to yourself speak. It's obvious you want to kill your mother before her time. You know you are what she's got.
Then I'll stay.
Stay where? Here? Supriya. That means you want your family to kill me. Think about this, man. Think about it. This will ruin your family's reputation.
My sister died having an abortion. I don't want to die.
Nothing will happen to you, okay? I'll take you to a professional doctor. Everything will be fine, I'll show you. I'll stand by you, I'll be by your side, okay? You don't have anything to worry about. Right?
You made me have an abortion at the expense of my life.
What? Oh my God, no.
Marry me and no one else.
What is this? Is this a joke or something? Are you crazy?
Crazy!
What else?
knife down, please.
Let you rock.
Hey, hey, baby.
You know rock till we die. Just you and I.
Baby,
huh?
Baby, put the knife. Come on, please put the knife down.
Shut
up. Please, please, hey, hey, hey. Put that down, down, knife, please.
Let you rock, huh?
So you talk to me. What happened?
I hardly take things seriously.
I don't get it.
The tape. I never bothered to see what was in the tape until I became his victim. I didn't even remember.
What was on the tape?
I killed my only sister in an abortion.
What did you come to tell me in my class yesterday?
I'm pregnant.
You're pregnant?
Yes.
Get up. I said, get up! I saw him lived here.
What did he say? Talk.
He threatened to kill me if I don't go with him for the abortion.
Abortion?
Yes.
Are you pregnant for him?
Yes.
You're pregnant for him all this while and you didn't tell me?
I was scared. I was scared of telling you.
Take my leave now. Where did you say you should meet him tomorrow?
At the front of the library. By night.
Which hospital are you supposed to meet him?
I don't know.
You don't know?
He couldn't tell me.
Wait, wait. Okay. Where are you meeting him?
In the library. Where? At the front of the library.
9 o'clock, you said.
Yes.
I still love you.
So, how is she? How is she?
Man, talk to me. How is she?
You see, there was a little complication. She lost it. I mean, she lost a lot of blood. You see.
Let me go and see her then.
No, don't bother yourself. You see, you know, I'm still attending to her. I'll get back to you. Just wait a minute. I'll get back to you. No, please, I'm coming.
The scene of his wedding.
Yes.
So what about the tape? Where is it now?
It's in my family house. I hid it away.
We need it. It could set you free. How do we get hold of it?
Freedom. I don't need it.
Able to get you people to see this tape. Doctor!
Who do you really say you are?
Doctor! get it? When did you get it?
Sir, our advice will go over and save her. Agape time for introduction is definitely going to come. She's in a lot of trouble and her life is in utmost danger. She killed the man on his wedding day.
And right now, she's in jail. My own daughter. My daughter.
And in the next minute, she could be hung.
This is so long, guys.
My daughter could be hung. Why are you still alive?
No, that cannot happen.
That cannot happen. It cannot happen.
Can we go
there? Don't give me that thing. It cannot happen. Not when I'm alive. Let me have that thing fast.
Thank you.
Call this thing for me and go and watch it first before commanding. Emmanuel, bring my daughter from that place.
Your daughter?
My daughter, I said. Bring her down from there.
Bring her down!
Very, very sorry. Very, very, very sorry.
That boy was indeed a man. And anyone who eliminated him before he destroys more innocent girls, his society must be commended to do a good job.
My lord, it's not because you're saying it. That boy indeed was a bloody animal.
Well, sir, if you will agree with me, this has inflicted on your reputation as a respected athlete and your esteemed family an indelible dent.
Beg your pardon, can you be more explicit, Inspector?
Inspector, such an insinuation is utterly offensive, for God's sake.
Commander, girls from responsible and respectable homes are responsible and command plenty of respect.
They don't what?
Inspector,
tell us! That they don't fall in love.
Commander, you need to understand where I'm coming from.
No, I need to understand where you're heading.
It's okay, that's okay. Don't join issues with him. Inspector, I want to believe you have daughters. Just pray you don't find yourself in such a messy situation someday. And no matter what anybody thinks about this incident, as far as I'm concerned, I am very, very fortunate. You may not be as fortunate.
I am surprised that an inspector of your own caliber would talk in such a nasty manner.
Inspector, the problem you are having
is that you seem to blink at the fact that children nowadays go through various pairs of orientation while in school, contrary to the kind of orientation we parents give to them while at home. What are you saying?
That's why this boy is that cunning and deceptive. This has nothing to do with sentimentality. We are treating issues.
And in your wildest imagination, who do you guess owns that law?
The law. It doesn't matter who is involved in this. The law must take its course.
Very well then. I am through with you. I'll see you in court.
My lord, please.
Okay. Inspector, you are going to deserve some respect, for God's sake.
No, nonsense is that. What nonsense? Listen, Corporal, what do those people think?
That I'm prepared to throw in the towel in a professional manner? They are dreaming. And the earlier they realize that, the better for them.
Sir, if you know lawyers very well, sir, they don't dream that kind of dreams.
At least they dream. Whatever. They should be ready for me. They should be ready for a face-off with me.
Pardon me, sir, if I ask this one more question, sir. But what kind of face-off?
I like doing things my own way. I know what to do about it.
I'm afraid, sir, that might be ridiculous. Yes, it might be ridiculous. Because they are most certainly going to bask in a high drama razzle-dazzle. Let's see about that.
Come on, sit down.
That inspector is as crazy as what he's fighting for.
Well, maybe he has a point. Perhaps they will not give our children proper upbringing.
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, you see, no matter the negative influence, how strong it may be, between the child's peers, a well-oriented child at home will never deviate nor go astray.
I don't understand what I'm talking about. Since when has it become a thing to go into an affair? What I just mean, that's all.
Well, that actually wasn't a love affair, it was a sexual relationship.
A lot of girls do it these days.
I remember vividly well that I never had kind of knowledge of you before I got married. I never impregnated you. I never aborted any pregnancy, neither did I damage a womb in the process.
Then fight for the illegality of abortion in this country. After all, you're one of the constituents of the law. Oh, you stop her from having sex!
That's alright, but you see, if they must have sex, then they must be ready to get married. That's the bottom line.
I don't care how you feel. That inspector better pray that the doctors confirm my daughter fits to leave the hospital. Otherwise, hell will let loose.
Well, come on, woman, play it down.
Okay.
Let's take it easy.
Okay. Please, just calm down, sir. Please. Sir, if you will agree with me, sir, I'll suggest you don't fight this fight anymore, sir. Please. Just take it easy, sir. Please.
Corporal.
Sir.
I've gotten to a point of no return. No, I can't.
No, sir, please, you can. Sir, please, you can. Now, see, sir, as far as those tapes and the personalities in the middle of this case are concerned, sir, that girl is innocent as pronounced.
She's not. She's a victim of her stupidity. Listen, Copper, how could she have accepted to go for an abortion when it was the same thing that killed her sister?
Sir, maybe because of her future and her family background.
What about her future and her family background? Corporal, murder is a punishable offense. She has to pay.
But, sir, need I remind you that that girl's father is a chief judge?
And so what?
You will get her off the hook, sir. She will live again. The most we can get off this case wouldn't be any better than a few years' sentence. Yes, and I even doubt that, sir.
That's impossible.
Sir, he has got enough evidence to set her free forever. Besides, sir, that girl has been in jail for so long. Sir, try to understand. Please, be human, sir. She can't afford to go back there, sir. Please. Please.
I'm not joking.
that boy were alive, he would have been compelled to face the wrath of the Lord. God, what would that boy need? Was ominous.
There isn't much you can achieve against these people.
I never knew a beast of a boy came to marry my daughter. But I smelt a rotten rat the moment I spotted those people today.
It was sure worse than a beast. Anyway, Chief, as a law enforcement agent, I have weighed the gravity of your late son-in-law's offense. And I think it would be in the best interest of your esteemed family to drop the case.
If there is any case that should be dropped. In point of correction, I have no son-in-law, living or dead.
That is not good to your reputation as a chief.
I have had enough embarrassment of it. A case involving that rotten ebb will never further steer me to untruthful direction. Not anymore. Go back to your station and face your business. I have to face my daughter.
Chief, tell me, how do you now convince your daughter that the case is not worth fighting?
Should that cost me another headache? I believe that the members of the police force in this country work in consonant with one another, irrespective of their location or stations. If possible, let that girl take you to that quack jack that spoiled her womb. He has to face the music.
He has to face the music. No doubt about that. And I think the one that killed her sister deserves to dance to the music as well. Chief, I have to take my leave now, Chief.
Yes. I talk to you again.
Okay, well,
you have to take care.
Okay, sir.
See you again.
Thank you.
protected your sister before he took her away from me. Firstly, he raped her. Secondly, he forced her to start dating him. And afterwards, he killed her. I made up my mind to pay him back no matter when.
The tape. How did you get the tape?
I took shots.
I don't understand you. Are you a cameraman?
You don't have to be a cameraman. I paid somebody to follow him up and take shots of whatever he does.
You must have a lot of money.
It has nothing to do with money. I love Daphne, your sister, so much. I made my mind to avenge her debt. I'm glad he paid for his deeds. I just wished you watched that tape before you started dating him.
I thought it was a whole movie. And I hated home movies. I was wrong. And I was late. I know. Thank you.
You're welcome. So what do I offer you?
I wish I could take something. Thank you. Right here. We have to get home. Thank you.
You see? I wished no word about my hunch, about the entire situation. I knew he hurt her terribly.
And what did he do to her?
Your daughter married the beast.
Daddy!
Shut up! He dated the sister of the girl that killed him. He impregnated her. Killed her during abortion.
What?
As if that was not enough damage, he also dated the girl that killed him, impregnated her, and took her where her womb was damaged during abortion.
My God.
And abandoned her there, just for your daughter.
My God.
For a year, or thereabout, she never knew his whereabout until that day, that fateful day, she found him on that cursed wedding day and killed him.
Jesus. Oh, Jesus.
Killed him.
Kashmir.
Jesus Christ. I never knew Kashmir was this mean. Pity? Always make sure you know those you make friends with, including those you get married to.
But how do we know them?
By their fruit, you shall know them.
But must they abort the pregnancies after impregnating the girls?
That is what the sinful kids of this generation are. That boy must be sitting right beside the devil. I don't ever want to hear any more about that evil child in this house. That boy was a sick boy. He tarnished the image of this family and deserves to burn in hell.
I'm in chains, I'm in pains. Under the sky, all alone, in the
rain.
You
haven't told me your name.
Under the sky, there is pain, there is gain.
Why do you hate homos?
Nothing, they just don't interest me.
No, I don't hold that view.
And a lot of people don't.
Why?
Home movies are quite educative. If you are used to watching them, they would have helped you a great deal.
So when you knew I hated home movies, why didn't you tell me what was in the tape?
To avoid interception. The contents of the note would have convinced you it wasn't.
Yeah. My friend Fina tried to convince me, but I don't take anything serious. My mistake.
Very sorry about that.
It's okay.
Anyway, I'll take you to see those fake doctors.
Who?
The fake doctors. The doctors that are behind all this problem.
No, they destroyed the happiness in my home.
Not completely. Because you're not dead. After all attempts to take your life in the hospital.
How did you know about that?
Do you remember Tiger?
Yes. You know him? He used to come to my ward.
I am Tiger.
What? Oh my God! You know, each time I try to... Each time I try to take my life out of frustration, something keeps waking me up.
That would be your sister's spirit.
No. If she was alive, she wouldn't have let him destroy my life before coming to see me.
You won't understand. Or later.
How do you know?
I'm going to take you somewhere. But right now, I guess it's pretty late. You have to go home.
You're right. Thank you.
You're welcome once again.
And sympathize with them.
I think you're right. I need it more than you do. I said a lot of horrible things to them.
Well, in that case, let's be fast about it. But how are we sure they have not left town?
No. They haven't. I'm very sure about that. But just to confirm it, let me call. Wait. Yeah, hello. Commander, it's Inspector Godwin. Yeah, please, I just want to confirm if the Chief Judge and his family are still in town. Okay, they are beautiful. Please, can I get the address of where I can find them? Uh-huh. Okay. Thanks a lot.
Yeah. Bye.
Chief Rabbit.
Thank you.
Let's go.
Sir, I'm very sorry for the entrances I made, sir.
It's alright. You were mad at me at your work, Inspector.
Sir, I'm bad. Please, I want you to find a place you know how to forgive me. And
I don't know.
No problem. Not to worry.
Sir, this is Chief Philip Ingle, the father of the boy's bride.
I see. Hello, Chief.
Hello, sir. Sir, I'm very sorry for what you have gone through all this while. I don't know why our kids are like this. How could a sane creature be so malicious for nothing?
I quite wonder myself. See, we were not brought up to be wild in our own time.
Once again, I'm very sorry. How I wish we knew the truth early enough. That poor girl's life would have been wrested just like that.
Have been worst moment of my life until
that I commanded the killing of an innocent girl. Someone I don't even know whether she's guilty or not. Inspector, it would have been terrible.
Terrible. Her afflictions have been so much.
But what baffles me most is why she didn't open up before the court.
Well, I guess she was frustrated. Having lost her pride as a woman and caused or killed a fellow human being, if you know what I mean. Probably she felt there was no use.
It's unbelievable. Sir,
from the look of things, I think your daughter is innocent. And I promise to do all within my reach. Make sure she regains her freedom.
Yes, we will do everything we can to make sure she regains her freedom.
Inspector, I agree with you. Because already we have enough evidence to tender in the court. So I believe that her freedom will be guaranteed.
Well, gentlemen, we cannot but thank you for being there and for understanding the situation. I have always felt this way too, that my daughter will be vindicated someday. And on behalf of my family, my wife, myself, and my children, and the entire world of justice and equity, I want to appreciate you and thank you very much for being on the side of justice. So once again, thank you very much.
I appreciate it.
I can't believe she's dead.
I wish she were not. Well, you know that's not possible. The court announced judgment on her a long time ago.
I'm going to look for her.
How do you mean? Are you out of your mind?
Baby, I really don't know why she wouldn't tell anyone the motive behind her actions.
Dr. Charles, I've been watching you very closely. What do you feel for her? Why do you care so much for a murderer?
I spoke to her. I know her heart is bitter. I feel a pain.
Sometimes I just wish we didn't have all this place.
Thank you.
Friend? Who are you? And what are you up to?
Never mind. The only time is right. Just come.
Come. Not come.
What are you doing here all alone? You're still crying?
You destroyed my life.
No. Like I told you the other day, your happiness was not completely destroyed.
Why did you take me to that hospital yesterday?
I just wanted you to know that your womb was not destroyed. Your womb is intact.
What do you mean?
You heard me.
You?
I planned it. I did it. I did it for your sister. I actually planned it with the doctor to make you believe your womb was destroyed, even while it was intact. That was the only way you can know the true nature of Kashmir. It was so self-centered. It never would have been there for you.
My God!
I would like you to start crying. Calm down. If I hadn't done that, you probably would have died like your sister. Now your happiness has been restored. I want you to be happy. I have to really take my leave. My mission has been accomplished. Goodbye.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You gave me a star.
control. Yeah, I'm in chains.
I'm in chains.
Oh no.
Under the sky.
Under the sky.
Sky.